Taylor Swift faces off against the American Civil Liberties Union, aka the ACLU. This all started when a website called PopFront, a site that quote boasts culture and politics from the left coast, did an analysis that seemed to imply that there were certain elements of Taylor Swift's lyrics and music that aligned, if weren't necessarily like coordinated to support certain terms in white supremacy. They write, while pop musicians are not respected world leaders, they have a huge audience and their music often reflects their values. So Taylor's silence is not innocent, it is calculated. And if that's is not true, she needs to state her beliefs out loud for the world, no matter what fan base she might lose. Because in America 2017, silence in the face of injustice means support for the oppressor. So they were asking her to come out and take a stance against, you know, possible accusations that she was echoing things that were said by white supremacists. Taylor's team then hit back and did essentially an injunction against these folks, saying that their post was baseless fiction masquerading as fact. But the ACLU holds that this is an issue of freedom of speech, and digital rights attorney Matt Cagle writes, intimidation tactics like these are unacceptable. Not in her wildest dreams can Miss Swift use copyright law to suppress this exposure of a threat to constitutionally protected speech.
This sort of overreach will always be out of style.
And they knew she was trouble.
To shake it off, but she should go elsewhere.
Is this the 1930s?
That is not gorgeous. Look what she made her do.
Yeah. Let's do thoughts, five words or less.
ACLU was ready for it.
But will this hurt her reputation?
Look what you made them do.
Look what you made me sue. You know,
good.
I thought that would be better than that. No,
you didn't sound like very confident about it.
Look what you made.
I don't know.
See.
I was trying to do the cadence of the song. So, all right. There's a lot in here. One of them is, how much responsibility does Taylor Swift have to say, I do not support white supremacy? Go.
Teacher. Okay, listen. When you are a celebrity, because in the article, they say that, you know, if you don't denounce, then you are complicit, you are in cahoots with the oppressor, right? My thing was, Taylor Swift, if she was as good of a person as the Swifties like to think she is, and if she was being told that she's in alignment with these bad people, why would she not naturally want to come out and say, hey, I'm not part of the Aryan Nation, I'm not a white supremacist, I'm not a neo-Nazi? Like, naturally, if I was being accused of that, I would, as a good person, say, you know, that's not what I'm about, you guys. You know, you should know this. You know, it's bad for my brand, because Taylor Swift is very in control of her very calculated, very put together brand and trajectory of her career. So from a business standpoint, because Taylor Swift allegedly is a fantastic businesswoman, you would think that she would get in front of them and be like, nope. Put the butts on that.
It seems she doesn't want to be in that conversation. Yeah. I would appreciate not wanting to be part of that narrative.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
And so it seems to me that she is very calculatedly saying, I'd rather have my legal team throw an injunction out there or some kind of thing.
Fuck her.
Than even say anything about their claims.
But she shot herself in the foot, because this is the Streisand effect. This article was published September 5th. We're now talking about it. PopFront, when it was originally released, estimated that they had about 100 clicks on the article. Now it has close to 100,000, because we're all talking about it. We're like, PopFront, what is this website? Now people are digging into it. It's this this woman, she runs this blog, Megan Herning is her name, while she is also, I think, in law school as well. So this is now, again, it's the Streisand effect. So Taylor, this was not a good move on your part. Have any of you guys read the full article?
I read, there's a quote from the article that was like,
but what I would just like to say about it is that it is all over the place. Yeah. I don't know why her legal team called attention to this article. They talk about American eugenics in the 1900s. There's a lot of, there's this comparison of imagery between Hitler and Taylor Swift. And then at the end, there is this coherent conclusion that they come to, saying that her innocence is calculated, and that they take issue with her being apolitical, which I think is a good discussion to have. But for her team to come down on this specific article is very strange.
Which makes me think that she just has part of her legal team dedicated to finding stuff like this and getting it taken down. And this is just one of many. That's the only thing I can think of.
You think there might be other cease and desist letters floating out there?
Yeah, of course. There's gotta be. I mean, because I know that in producing videos and whatever for however long I've done it, there are certain entities that you stay away from, and typically it's been like Disney, Scientology, and Major League Sports, because they just have an apparatus there to just go get shit taken down. It's not so much that they would find yours and be like, yours is especially terrible. It's like yours falls into this category of things we don't want out there, so we're gonna put a cease and desist letter.
Brittany has the same thing, where they have a team that scours the internet to just extract and remove anything that's bad about Brittany. But in Taylor's defense though, you brought up the article, Grace. The author says, quote, "It is an established fact that Taylor Swift is secretly a Nazi and is simply waiting for the time when Donald Trump makes it safe for her to come out and announce her Aryan agenda to the world." Now, for anyone, I mean, even though that sounds ridiculous, I put myself in Taylor Swift's, no one likes being accused of something that they're not, right? So I don't blame Taylor Swift's people for saying, hey, look, shut the F up, you know, this is bullshit. I would, if I was a celebrity and someone was saying Jason beats men, which is not true, I would want someone, you know, that I've hired to come to my defense and handle that, you know? So I don't blame them for what they're doing to Taylor. I just think that I don't like Taylor. I know I'm gonna get a lot of hate in the comments section below. I don't care.
I don't think you will.
Taylor, something, she's so calculated.
I'll give you all that hate.
She's so, because you're waiting for that album to drop tonight, aren't you, Brett? You Swifty. Where's it? Katie Katz, where you at? Katie Katz, where you at? Is that still a thing? Are they still in Kuta? But I mean, I don't blame Taylor's people for coming to bat and saying, listen, this has to go.
I don't think she comes out and is political because the parents of a lot of her fans are probably Donald Trump supporters.
Yeah, I think that's what it is. I mean, whether it's Donald Trump supporters or not, a lot of
they're more conservative.
Are less likely. There are fewer parents that are more likely to support someone who's super political.
Yeah.
It's just a dominant strategy for her to stay out.
And that's her base.
Coming out and being like, hey, I don't like white supremacy on Twitter, just that tweet alone,
it's the next, and I get it, you're right. It's easy to tweet literally anything, and it's not a crazy controversial political stance,
but it's apolitical against Nazis.
But is it fair?
It just seems like she's made a very high level decision. If she has like her goal board and out there, like things she wants to accomplish, getting political is not one of them. And the discipline that she's displayed throughout her career, it doesn't seem crazy to think that she would avoid any kind of political statement, regardless of how innocuous it may seem. But
is
I don't
that know. Fair though? Like, real quick, is that, I mean, do is it fair for us being just normal everyday people to attach that kind of responsibility for these stars that have to have an opinion, for have to have a stance because
I think it's our responsibility. I think it's our responsibility to do stuff like that, and it should be their responsibility to speak up. So that
celebrity
has
definitely evolved in the past 20 years to a point where I think that they need to be responsible for talking about.
I mean, we elected a reality star as our president. I mean, he's a businessman, but then he became a huge reality star. So.
I know, but I mean, we say there, but should we vilify them? Like, let's say I'm a huge celebrity and I don't want to speak out about politics, and I'm an inherently good person. Should I automatically become a public enemy because I don't like because I keep mum about the situation? Like, why is it my responsibility to throw myself in the trenches of things?
I think it depends on how serious the issue is. If the issue is very serious and very real, then the more serious and more real it gets, the more you should speak out about it. And it's up to everyone, individual, to write their own line, and it's up to you. It's up to the celebrity to write that line down, and it's up to you to make your own decision about how much you want to hold them responsible for it, given their position. It's a sliding scale.
Authenticity is important, though, because we also vilify celebrities who, and I know we got to wrap, sorry, I'll shut up in a minute. We also come for celebrities that want to jump on, like, the feminism bandwagon, when they know, when they weaponize that, but it's like, we want authenticity. So if I'm not authentically feeling a way about something, I should stay mum about it.
I mean, I get it. And I think authenticity can just be as simple as articulating how you, that exact sentiment. Because that's something that's genuine, and people, it will resonate with people to say, listen, I just don't know. I'd love to have the conversation to learn more, but I don't feel like an authority on it. And I've heard that, and I've accepted it from a lot of people. Like, Conan O'Brien says, funny man, just be funny. He doesn't want to get too political, but he has when it has gotten more and more serious. Right. So it is a sliding scale, and it's one that if we all are more talkative and communicative about it, then we'll all learn to understand each other better. But what do you think? Don't give me your true feelings, just give me praise, and we'll see you next time.